So my first fighting game was in fact Mortal Kombat 2. My first fighting game I actually learned how to play competently was Tekken 2. After getting my PlayStation at the age of 6 or 5, doesn't really matter, that first lineup of games for my PlayStation changed my life. And Tekken was a huge part of that. I'm actually glad I got Tekken 2 first, because I don't think my 6-year-old self would have liked Tekken 1 or appreciated it for some reason. The game was magical. I remember unlocking Bake as my first unlockable character, and after learning how to spam backflips with Law, I was just amazed with the game. Funnily enough, Bake ended up being my main in Tekken 5 on, but the rest is history. I have a very rich history with this series, and I've loved every game besides one in Advanced. I even play competitively, as you've seen on my channel, and I've competed in tournaments in Tekken 6 and Tekken Tag 2. The series has always held a special place in my heart, and that's why looking at it recently has me worried. So, Tekken 7 was announced, quote-unquote, unintentionally last year's Evo, the biggest fighting game tournament in the world. We got a small teaser, people complained about not seeing gameplay, but teasers are teasers. Later on, we actually get footage, and the complaints started rolling out even more. Not to say that there aren't any good things said about the game at all, but I started to realize then that where Harada was going with the series. Now, this is a critique of the practices and the current atmosphere of the game for me, but my intention is not to bash Harada or his team, but to kind of get an understanding of what he's trying to do. Now, as a tournament player, I do value gameplay mechanics over the story and all that extra stuff, and in the realm of game mechanics, I was for making the game accessible. I'd rather have more people play the game than, you know, having a game like Tekken Tag Tournament 2 where the mechanics pushed away newer players. Now, that's not to call Tekken Tag Tournament 2 a bad game, but Tekken after Tekken 7 has been a very inclusive and iterative series. If you've been playing this series for a while competitively, you have a long list of special skills that can be applied to every Tekken game, and it takes a long time for most people to attain and utilize those skills that playing one game would not be enough. So Rada, for the most part, not to go into specific mechanics, has done a good job to quote-unquote dumb down the game, from what I can tell, but there are issues elsewhere. When people look at Tekken 7, they say it looks the same, and I have to agree. Even as a player who can see and understand things that the casual, my preferred term, non-competitive player can't, it still looks like Tekken, and if Harada and by extension Namco want to attract a bigger audience, they need to actually put effort into making the game look new. It needs to look like Tekken, because that's what the returning purchaser wants. But at the same time, they want to have something new, or have something that looks new. Tekken has always sort of had this weird recycled but fresh feel to this series that disappeared in some instances that leads to the reaction it's getting. Having characters and new looks in each game disappeared for the sake of having them look recognizable like the Street Fighter characters. This was a completely unnecessary move. Before the characters, each carried a theme to their looks like Paul's hair or King's wrestling outfits that made them recognizable. This almost completely disappeared after Tekken 5 to the series' detriment. It does not help a person looking at the game and say, this looks new. You want to attract the person to the newness of the game, and for Namco, in a lot of cases, to not up their outfits is silly. That's not even going back to the lack of two-player costumes for the sake of customization, which was fine in Tekken 5 and Tekken 6. And that's not getting into the recycled animations, which would be fine if the new rage arts weren't not unique-looking supers. A lot of them that aren't from the new cast members in the game are really bland and are pretty much generic riffs on moves that are already in the command list. The nice cinematography is wasted a lot of the time because there's no emotion in the attacks besides a few like King's or even like Yoshi's that feels actually unique. Hell, the new character Josie's is a ripoff of Ajiba's Critical Edge in Soul Calibur 5. I get the need for recycling, I really do, but when it comes to the cost of making your brand new feature look completely boring, you need to go back to the drawing board. Sum things up, Tekken 7 need to feel new regardless if there's going to be a large shift in gameplay like Tekken 4 or not. If they wanted to go the safe route and tweak what they already had to make it more accessible, they should have gave the game the paint it deserved instead of just splashing a bit here and there. The sad part is Tekken 7 is pretty much done concept-wise. I seriously doubt they're going to make an update to the game so much as to make it look new. I feel like all the nice changes for the newer players are wasted because the game just looks generic and they may not want to touch the game. There's a lot of instances of this in the game, but it would be redundant to really touch on those. I fear for the game is that it'll be pretty decent, but it will sell less than Tekken Tag Tournament 2. These are just some simple concerns. And I feel like I could be wrong, but hey, it's just something to think about. I love Tekken. It's my favorite, one of my favorite fighting game series. I do not want to go the route of my other favorite fighting game series, Soul Calibur. Yeah, I should do that in my next video. Anyways, thank you for watching my first Mike Looks At. Next one, maybe Soul Calibur, maybe something completely different, but nonetheless, it's something to watch. Thank you guys for watching, and peace.